Hello, geniuses. Today, I am happy to share with you a new video series that is part of our very own Genius Academy, the Crypto Basics series. As you may know, the Genius Academy will be a place where everyone, this includes both seasoned traders and newcomers alike, is given the right set of information to understand the world of cryptocurrency and decentralized finance. The Crypto Basics series will be aimed at newcomers who are just starting to discover all the benefits that the world of DeFi has to offer. If this sounds like you, then please let our Crypto Basics series be your introductory guide to the exciting world of cryptocurrency. Part 1. Blockchain. A blockchain is a digital ledger in the form of a series of blocks containing structured information that are linked together, with each new block using a specific string of information from the previous block. To use the Bitcoin blockchain as an example, each block contains some defined information, including a collection of recent transactions, a reference number, known as a cryptographic hash, from the previous block, and ultimately a cryptographic hash of all the information in the new block, which will then be appended to the next block. It is this method of creating a hash and appending it to the following block that creates a chain. And it is the chaining of blocks that give it security and immutability. If one block is tampered with, it changes the output hash of that block, which invalidates every other block in front of it. This means the further back in time a completed block is, the less likely it is that the information in it can ever be changed. With the amount of computing power now competing to validate Bitcoin blocks, it is almost impossible to imagine that anyone could successfully change a block to include something malicious, and then be able to overpower the sheer amount of honest nodes that are constantly adding new valid blocks to the chain. Since the participants in the Bitcoin network are distributed, rather than centralized, and this process of recording new transactions is akin to keeping a shared ledger of who has paid who, it is also often referred to as a distributed ledger, or DLT, which stands for Distributed Ledger Technology. Let's compare a blockchain-based transaction with a more common centralized method that most of us have grown up with. When person A wants to pay person B $20, they log into their internet banking account and send a payment. Behind the scenes, person A's bank checks if they have sufficient funds in their account, and if so, makes a debit for the amount in their account, and forwards the payment to person B's bank, who updates their ledger to credit the amount into person B's account. In this case, both people need to have verified bank accounts, and at all times, the banks are in control of whether or not the payment can occur. In a distributed ledger model using blockchain, anyone with a computer and internet access can send value to another user across a network who also has internet access. When this transfer occurs, everyone running a copy of the Bitcoin software has the record of the transaction, meaning the system is more open and accessible. It is these features of being open, accessible, immutable, and secure that have solidified the importance of blockchain technology and driven its adoption into more and more applications. Alright, this concludes our first Crypto Basics series video on the topic of the blockchain. Make sure to subscribe to this channel if you'd like to stay informed about Genius Academy, and follow us at the different social media accounts that will be shared in the description box below. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for our next video on the topic of decentralized finance.